was this my coworker for the past decade, really, but also my soul sister, my sister in fitness, my TV wife, all of the above, because we have cried together more times than Lord can count at this point in the back dressing room. And she helped me get through a lot. I've helped her get through a lot. And I also got to witness her amazing journey of losing 100 pounds, landing the cover of a magazine, being able to go on and inspire people with her new brand, Decide to Live. So everybody, please put your hands together for my amazing fitness sister, Jessica Larchet.
We can't even look at each other. We just cry all the time. All right, no crying. There's no crying in baseball. Take the mic.
Well, there's plenty of crying along the journey. Good tears, happy tears, sad tears, all the tears.
All the tears.
Kristen, God bless you and thank you. Give her a round of applause for bringing us all together today. Oh, I can't look at you.
Stop looking at me. We cry every time. We've had many, I like to say, counseling sessions
in the dressing room at News 3.
We swap roles. Sometimes we're the counselor, sometimes we're the patient, but we have always been there for each other. And when I hit my 100-pound weight loss mark in, praise the Lord, in 2015, Kristen was actually the second person I told. The second person. The first I told was my husband, Sean, because I woke him up at 3 a.m. I was like, baby, you see the scale? It means I lost 100 pounds. And then I ran to work and told Kristen, and she gave me this beautiful necklace to commemorate it. So thank you so much for being there for me. I love you. You are my sister, and I thank you so much for putting this together. All right, everybody, stand up. Let's go. Everybody, stand up. Somebody said, wait, I was still eating my snacks. Wait a minute. Everybody standing up. I need everyone to repeat after me. Are you ready? One day at a time.
One day at a time.
Oh, that was not enough soul in there. Let's try that again. One day at a time.
One day at a time.
One moment at a time.
One moment at a time.
I decide to live.
I decide to live.
Give yourselves a round of applause. All right. Go ahead and have a seat. Well, as Kristen said, my name is Jessica Larchet, and I am an encourager through the gift of storytelling. One of the ways I use my gift is as a morning anchor at News 3. Thank you all so much for your support. I know all of you are watching every single morning. Nod your head, yes, 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 absolutely. I also use my gift with my platform, JessicaOnAJourney.com, and the Decide to Live podcast. And I created these communities a few years ago when I was facing a mountain of my own with my toxic relationship with food that resulted in obesity. And I created it because of the lessons I'm learning along the way. And I've learned that the mountains that are in our lives are only gateways to our greatness. And when we learn to embrace the challenges we face in that way, we can see them as an opportunity to be champions, not as an opportunity to lose, because we were all created to win. So I need everyone to take out your phones for a second. I want to give you a snapshot of my journey. Hop up on the Instagram. I know y'all have the gram, as the kids like to say. And I want to just share with you a quick snapshot of my journey. Go to Decide to Live TV. It's going to be a blue icon with white letters. When you reach it, say amen. We got some amens back there. Some more amens are waiting for in the front. Decide to Live TV. And you're going to see the first post up there to the left. And that is a snapshot of my journey. On the left is Jessica at 270 pounds. I'm 5'2", so you can imagine the pressure that the weight was putting on my body at the time. And on the right is Jessica, around 90 pounds lighter at the time. It's a snapshot, just a moment in time of my journey. Just one line separates the two pictures, but what a journey in between. Now, here's the difference between those two pictures. Has nothing to do with my worthiness, has nothing to do with my beauty. The difference between those two pictures, just a series of decisions to live. This was the mountain that I faced in my life. So I grew up in New Orleans. I'm from NOLA. And there, NOLA, all right. Crawfish etouffee, beignets, all right. But when you grow up in New Orleans, food is a part of our culture. Food is a part of the family. But I started to recognize it wasn't just that I was enjoying Mardi Gras and all the beautiful celebrations of our culture we had there. I had a different relationship with food, and I noticed even when I was young, I would run downstairs in the middle of the night to eat. And I don't mean just getting a cookie here or there. I would make full meals. I would have something, you know, salty that I would warm up, and then I would go get snacks. And, you know, my mom would be wondering, what happened to the food? What's going on here? And so I was really active. My mom made sure, she's an incredible mother, she made sure I was active. I was in cheerleading. I was on dance team. I was in dance classes, but for some reason I was still putting on weight that was a bit of a concern at the time. But when I went to college, to Florida A&M University, I noticed that something was different. I didn't have the cheerleading. I didn't have the dancing any there to kind of head things off. And I realized I had a toxic, bad relationship with food. The scale went up to 270 pounds, which means I gained about 80 pounds in college. We are not talking about the freshman 15, that when you get there, you're on your own and you can eat what you want and it's great. And it's like, oh, my pants feel a little snug. No, it was clear that I had a bad relationship, an addictive relationship with food. And I'll never forget one night, because I was a perfectionist, I still am a little bit, but I was beating myself up that day for being overweight. And so what did I do? I self-medicated with the very thing that I was disappointed in myself about at the time. I went to Popeyes and I got a complete family meal, probably 8 pieces of chicken. I got 2 large sides, 5 biscuits. Thank God they didn't have those sandwiches back then. Lord have mercy. But then I took that and then I went to the grocery store and I got an entire key lime pie. And I went back to my apartment and I ran upstairs so my roommates wouldn't see me. And I sat in my bed and I ate all of it. And I just remember crying and feeling numb and feeling so disgusted with myself because I didn't know why I was doing what I was doing. And I started crying. I threw on some clothes at the time. And I called my mom on the phone and I was driving. I didn't know where I was driving. I could barely see on the road, but I just knew that I was in trouble. And I drove to a place in Tallahassee called Lake Ella. And I remember just asking God while I was there, what is wrong with me? Why did you make me this way? And so that's when it became clear that I had some work to do. So I had some motivation at first, but it was very superficial motivation for me at the time. I wanted to look cute at the club with my sorority sisters and wear the cute little dresses and the heels, and that's what I wanted to do. But that type of motivation is fleeting. It doesn't last long. And so I found myself going back and forth with those habits, even as I was starting my career in television. And God sent me a wake-up call when my dad passed away. He died in the summer of 2011, and he was close to 500 pounds when he died. My dad was an incredible man. He was the kind of man who would give his heart to anyone. But in his past, he struggled with drug addiction, and it led to the end of his marriage with my mom, and it led to so many struggles in his life. And so he overcame that. He overcame that. But we learned that he replaced his addiction to drugs with an addiction to food. And I'll never forget being at his funeral, and he was in his casket. And he had this beautiful, curly salt and pepper hair. And I remember stroking his hair thinking, it didn't have to be this way. If only he had made different choices. And then a year later, I had my own blood pressure scare. I think it was 150 over 100 at the time. I was only 27 years old. And I left the doctor's office with a prescription for blood pressure in my hands. And I was crying. And I felt my dad's presence say to me, baby girl, you can make a different decision than I did. You can decide to live. So at the time, you hear people say, oh, I have high blood pressure, but you don't really understand why that's a problem. And that's when I made the connection that, oh my God, high blood pressure leads to heart disease, heart attack, stroke. And I realized that my relationship with food was putting me on track to experience those things. So I made God 2 promises that day. I said, I'm gonna eat better and I'm gonna exercise more. I didn't say, Jesus, I'm about to lose this 100 pounds in 6 months, I'm gonna get it popped. That's not what I said. I'm gonna eat better and I'm gonna exercise more. And I also made a commitment to go to therapy. Therapy is normal. I met an incredible, incredible psychologist who helped me unravel why I was binge eating. And it wasn't that I just liked food and couldn't stop eating. I kept downing myself for that. Like, why can't I just stop? And she helped me understand that I was eating to self-medicate for anxiety. And that those moments where I found myself binge eating, I was soothing panic attacks. And so she helped me deconstruct that. And so once I understood the why, I could start to do the work. And so over the course of several years, about 5 years, I came down 100 pounds. And so something, thank you so much. And something I want to say about that too, because everybody's journey is different. Everybody's healthy body looks different. Everybody's going to take a different amount of time. I was doing serious unraveling of generational work in my family, in my friends' families to do that work. And I had someone say to me, and let me be clear, 99.999% of the comments I get are very positive, very welcoming, very loving. But someone said to me, oh, it took you that long? And they were, you know, kind of wondering like why I didn't have a six-pack abs yet. I said, oh, Jesus, okay. Here's the thing. When you're unraveling generational choices, when you are going to therapy to understand the why, because you only want to be on a track forward, you know what I'm happy about? I'm not on blood pressure medication anymore. I don't have high cholesterol. I am no longer pre-diabetic. My mom works out 5 days out of the week. She'll be off of diabetes medication soon. And I know that my dad is in heaven cheering me on every step along the way. Take stock of your choices, the good choices you're making along the way, and allow your body to receive them the way that it will. One other tool that I used along this wellness journey, and I want to share this with you all because it's so important, it's about writing down your goals, writing the vision, and making it plain. So my incredible husband right here, Mr. Sean Malik Washington, wearing his Decide to Live shirt with his fine self. All right. He's gonna pass out some cards for you, and I'm gonna explain why while you're receiving them. You can take these home and think about this. But one of the things I did along my journey is I had some friends over, and we wrote down our visions on an index card. Just wrote them down on an index card about what we wanted to see for our lives, for our wellness journeys, what goals we had, desires we had. There is a lot of power in manifestation, writing out our goals, writing out what we want to see in our lives. And two of the main things that I wrote on that index card, as Sean is finishing up here, Kristen, actually, can you look in that box? You're gonna see a... Keep going. Yes, oh, it's right here. All right, here we go.
It's on the stage. Right?
Thank you. So one of the things I wrote on that vision card was that I wanted to do well enough along my journey that God would allow my story to be used to inspire people in a national way. And this was not about vanity. This is not like, oh yeah, I want to get on the cover and then, oh yeah. That's not what it was about. I knew other people knew what it was like to be locking themselves in their rooms, eating in shame, and then pretending like everything was fine, but secretly wondering what was wrong. So I wrote that vision. Okay, Lord, I want to do well enough to reach people who are in my same shoes. And in 2016, this time, this is Women's Day Magazine, and I got to share the cover with two other amazing, incredible women on their own wellness journeys. All of us lost 100 pounds or more over time. And I know we talk about weight as a metric for what things look like along the wellness journey. There's so much more. Like I said, the blood pressure, the cholesterol, what can you do with your body? How do you feel in your body? But this is this was incredible. This was a beautiful, beautiful manifestation of a dream I had. And again, it's not so much about the losing 100 pounds number. It was about being able to reach people across the country. The other thing I wrote on that card, which was not necessarily wellness journey related, was that I said, Lord, sweet baby Jesus, please bring me an amazing husband. And he did. So when you get home tonight or tomorrow morning at some point this week, when you have some quiet time and you can reflect, I want you to write down first three things you're grateful for. Start with gratitude. Sometimes we want to nitpick about the things we don't have and we don't see how amazingly blessed we are right now. Write down three things you are grateful for. And then I want you to write down three wellness visions you have for your life. And it doesn't have to be a number. It can be, you know what, I want to run a marathon within the next year. Or I want to be able to flip a tire. Or I just want to go up the stairs without leaning over and saying, whoo, Lord, can I get up? Whatever that wellness journey, you want to be able to run with your kids or with your grandkids. Whatever the picture is you have for your wellness journey, write that. Three things you're grateful for, three visions you have for your wellness journey. And I want to leave you with this. All of us have something in common with Olympians. All of us. Each of us has traces of gold floating around in our blood, through our veins. It's a very, very trivial, small amount, but that means you already possess the gold. You are already a champion. So when those challenges come in your life, know that you already have the victory. You have already won. And I hope you decide to live. Thank you all so much.
Jessica, you know I love her too.